And considering the fact that my client does come from a good home and family, that he has a respectable job, and that he has no prior criminal record, I ask Your Honor to show leniency in your sentencing. I would recommend a program of community work. Suspension of his driver's license for the minimum period of 3 years, with the understanding that he be required to complete a rehabilitative driving course before being allowed to drive any vehicle again. He's barely 18 years old, Your Honor. His actions were not deliberate. His conscience bears a terrible responsibility for what he's done. I am convinced that imprisonment is not the answer. I ask for leniency. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Dickinson. Mr. Phillips, arguments for the state?
Your Honor, when the jury delivered its verdict on this defendant, guilty on 8 counts of vehicular manslaughter, I recommended at that time that the sentence be as severe as the law allowed. 8 people did not have to die on that tragic Friday night 3 months ago. His conscience? What about the families and friends of those innocent victims? They'll be suffering with this tragedy for the rest of their lives. No, Your Honor. An example must be made of this offender's horrible crime. State once again recommends that you deal severely with this young man. Barely 18 or not.
Both arguments concerning the severity of my sentence have been persuasive. This is indeed a most grievous situation, and therefore requires careful deliberation. This court is in recess until 3 o'clock this afternoon.
Miller, John, 18 years old. No prior criminal offenses. One speeding ticket. One accident. Auto insurance canceled. No serious trouble with law. Until now. What do you do in a situation like this? What do you say to those victims' families? It wasn't premeditated murder. But you can't take it lightly either.
Good. Is this dry yet?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Don't eat anything. We're having dinner in a couple of hours.
Nah, I think I'll just grab some of the guys.
But your brother's coming for the weekend.
Great. More real exciting law school stories, huh?
But Sarah's coming with him.
Thank you. car, too.
Oh, shut up.
Hey!
Hey, Johnny!
Hey, Paul, what happened to your foot?
Well, you know me, Johnny. I was trying for a new major league record.
Don't believe him. Uh-huh. He dropped a shot put on it in the equipment room.
Yeah, you know what that means.
Team might win a few.
Real funny. So how's you been, Johnny? How's the new job?
That's not bad. I'm working hard. Not like you guys.
Hey, listen. Anybody want a beer?
Jeez, Johnny, not here. What are you, crazy?
Come on, put it away, Johnny. Maybe later.
Why don't we all get together tonight?
Hey, okay. Listen, I'll pick you up at the corner store in a few hours, and we'll pick up a few six-packs.
All right.
And if you're real good, I'll take you for a spin.
Yeah.
Okay, listen.
Have fun in school, boys and girls, and I'll see you at the corner store 2 hours now. Be there.
What's happening, bro?
Hey, don't do that, all right?
So can I get a lift or what?
Yeah, all right, get in.
How's it going, man? I never see you around anymore.
Yeah, man, well, I've been busy, you know, getting into shape.
Yeah.
Basic training starts as soon as school's over.
Ted Franklin
in the Navy. I still can't believe it.
Hey, listen, I'm gonna go pick up the guys.
Wanna come?
That sounds good to me.
Okay.
But hey, man, how can you listen to this garbage?
Hey, leave it alone, man.
Hey, John, look out!
Nice move, man.
I hope your insurance is going to cover that.
Come on, it's not that bad. And well, besides, I don't have any insurance.
I sort of ran into somebody last fall, remember?
And the lousy insurance company wouldn't pick me up again after the accident because, get this, they said I was a bad risk.
Yeah, that's you. Big bad, Jeff.
That's right, we bad.
Hey,
how you doing?
So listen, buddy, I want you to get more of this stuff, but get the good stuff. You hear me?
No one cares.
Yeah, right.
That was it.
Hey, you want some of this?
Oh, just what I need.
Hey, that's great. Ow. What kind of sister are you anyway, giving him some and not me? I gotta kill the pain in my foot.
What about the pain in your head, Bigfoot?
Hey, I'll give you Bigfoot.
Hey, Johnny, I hear there's a party down by the pond. You want to stop over there later?
Yeah, I heard about it, too. There's going to be a live band there. It's supposed to be really happening.
The pond? Come on, that's all the way in the next county.
Hey, man, who cares? A party's a party. Let's go, Johnny.
All right. All right, everybody pile in. I'm driving.
Hey, Johnny, is there a breath?
Johnny, can we go, too?
All right, come on, guys. Everybody. Hey, you too. Come on.
Paul, that foot is not sitting up here with me. You get back.
Oh, careful, get in. No, wait.
What's that on your shirt?
Oh, sucker.
Johnny! Oh, Johnny!
What?
I thought you said this thing could really go fast.
Johnny!
I have deliberated long and hard over this sentence. It is certainly not an easy decision to make. And I, unfortunately, have to make such decisions far too often. Of all the automobile fatalities that occur in the United States, one-third are single-vehicle accidents, where no other car and no other driver is involved, and half of those are caused by drivers under the age of 25. Like Johnny Miller. More than half of these accidents take place on nights like the one in question, where the driver, like Johnny Miller, has been drinking and is going to a party or some other social event. 87% of these drivers knew the area and were familiar with the road on which the accident occurred. Just like Johnny. The defendant will rise. I am within my legal rights to sentence you to from 3 to 5 years in prison for each of 8 counts of vehicular manslaughter. 24 to 40 years. Do you think that sounds harsh? Well, I'm not sure it is. The parents and friends of the people who died because of your actions demand some sort of repayment. How else are they to know that justice has been done unless a convicted criminal goes to jail? On the other hand, I could follow the recommendations of your attorney. Suspended sentence, take away your license, probation for 5 years. During that time, you would be obliged to do community work, perhaps even working with kids younger than yourself that might need a guiding hand. But why should I do that after what you've done? Those people in that truck were your friends. Every single one of them depended on you when you got behind the wheel that night. And you let them down. You took every risk in the book because you thought an accident could never happen to me. You've brought immeasurable grief and sorrow to their families and friends. Can I really let you continue to live the life you knew before this horrendous crime? I'm not sure. Tell me, Johnny, if you were up here in my place, what sentence would you pass on Johnny Miller? Speak up, boy! I'm asking you.